Hi everyone, Menachem Brodie here with you once again from Human Vortex Training, your certified and experienced strength and conditioning coach for cycling performance. We're here today to talk about rotary stability and rotary strength for power on the bike. What exactly is rotary or anti-rotational strength? What this is the ability to lock the rib cage, the spine, and the pelvis together as one unit so that you're able to actually move them together to get power on the bike as opposed to separating them where the hips turn one way and the rib cage turns another, which we often see. So one of the things that you're going to be able to see here in this video from one of the HVT athletes I coach is that his hips are moving side to side. You can see that through the markers on the back of the jersey. And this is something we really want to work against. He's a beginner cyclist, beginner triathlete as well. And what we've been working on is locking his rib cage and pelvis together. And this is one of the exercises which he's gotten and I'm going to give to you guys. Now this is the anti-rotation plank. So all we're going to need here, guys, is either a foam roller or a wooden dowel and something in front of you which to touch. What we're going to do is we're going to set up in a plank position, which so many of you are going to already know from your planking days, which you may be doing wrong. We'll have another video on that here as well. We're going to take the foam roller, putting it on through the just above the spine. We're going to move forward toward our kettlebell here. What we're going to do is start off on the elbows with the feet shoulder width apart. You're going to notice that the foam roller is nice and level here. The anti-rotation that we want to be able to keep that foam roller nice and level. When we reach ahead, touch the kettlebell, you'll notice it's moving just a little bit. Boom. We want to be able to hold this position nice and steady. What we don't want to see is reaching for the kettlebell, that the hips are rocking and it's moving side to side, the knees are bending, this is bad. So the beginners are going to start here on the elbows, just underneath the shoulders, just like we would for a good time trial position, keeping the glutes squeezed, the stomach tight, quads tight. You're just going to reach, reach. If this is too hard in your challenge, you can move forward towards the kettlebell to start off with a little bit less of a motion. And yes, that foam roller will want to move around. For those of you who are more advanced, we're going to take this up onto the hands. We're going to start off with the feet shoulder width apart. Down it goes. That's all right. We want to make sure the back is nice and straight. So a wooden dowel or a broomstick may work a little bit better. Over here, keep nice and tight. Boom. Notice that the foam roller is staying really nice, shoulder blades back and down, squeezing the glutes. And again, we don't want to see the foam roller roll around just like that. So this is your anti-rotational plank. Start off with a set about 20 seconds, three times each side. You'll notice your heart rate's going to come up, you're going to be breathing hard. But this is a beginner exercise to start to plant the seed in your body of how to lock your rib cage, your back, spine, and your pelvis together. So try this three times, 20 seconds, alternating hands. Take your time, make sure that foam roller is not moving around or that dowel is not moving around too much. And remember, until next time, train smarter, not harder, and it is all about you.